Hello guys, Vivek here, and today in this video I'm going to describe you about how does a tube light work. Okay, so we have been using tube light in our household application and also in offices or many areas you have been using it. So let us see how a tube light works. Okay, in the later slides I will be discussing about the same. So before going to tube light, how does a tube light works, I will describe you about, let us just know about what are inductors, okay, or a very brief overview of inductor, how does it works. Okay, so here is what called an inductor. This is called an inductor. Okay, so let us consider it is connected across a battery, plus and minus here. So what is the nature of inductor? Initially, is as the point is open, there is no current flowing through any part. But as soon as this is thrown off, okay, this is closed, so current begins to flow from here and here in this manner, right, from plus to minus. This is the direction of current. Now in that case there is the normal operation. But what happens if we open the switch? Okay, so if we open the switch, if the switch is open, like say it is open, it is in open condition, so what happens, there is no current flowing through the circuit, but the inductor is different from this. What happens in case of inductor? See, consider this equation. Okay, so what this equation says, ignore L and everything, see what is this, this is DI, that is the difference of current. Okay, what is the difference of current across the inductor? What is the difference? Initially say it was 5 ampere and now it is, as the switch is open, it is 0 ampere. So what is the difference of current? 5 minus 0, that is 5 ampere, right? And dt, what does it says? This says change of time or difference of time. So how much time it takes for the inductor current to go from 5 to 0 ampere, how much time it takes? It's just the time of switching it off, right? It is the only the time which is taken by the switch to go from on position to off position. So how much time it takes? Very few, very less, right? We can say that it is ideally 0 second. Okay, so dt is 0. So what is di by dt? What is di by dt here? What is di by dt? Di by dt is 5 by 0, of course, 5 upon 0. Okay, 5 upon 0 is what? Infinity, right? Anything upon 0 is infinite. So even value of E, what we see here is infinite. E is equal to infinite. But we see one more thing, that is L. So what is L? L is called the inductance. Okay, the value of impedance of this inductor is called inductance. Okay, so L multiplied to infinity is infinity, and there is a minus symbol. So because of that, what happens? A minus appears. Okay, so E is equal to minus infinity. Okay, this one. So E is equal to minus infinity. What is E now? E is the induced EMF, that is the voltage across this inductor. Okay, so voltage across this inductor, what it says, is infinite, that is very high voltage. And at the same time we see that E is equal to minus. Okay, E is given by this minus symbol. So what does this minus symbol indicates? It indicates that the polarity of this voltage of the inductor is opposite. That is, if say the source voltage is plus here and minus here, the EMF across this inductor will be, it will be plus here and minus here, just the opposite of the voltage source. So what happens now? See, I just erase everything. So we just saw that the plus appears over here and minus over here, and the voltage across this inductor is infinite. So what happens, because of this infinite voltage, as the plus is here, it will try to pull off a current from this direction, right? And it will just stop here. Okay, at this point the voltage, as we know, at the open terminal, what happens at the open terminal, whatever the voltage has been applied, that is seen across the open terminal. Okay, so in the same manner, as the infinite voltage is here, the current is discontinuous and this is open portion, so a voltage appears over here, that is infinite voltage appears. And this huge voltage, what it causes, this huge voltage ionizes the air between these two contacts. What is the meaning of ionization? What is the effect? The effect is a huge spark appears over here. Okay, a spark appears at this position. Okay, you have been noticing it when you are operating a pump or a motor of huge load, and suddenly if you switch it off, suddenly if the motor is switched off, a spark is seen behind the switch. This is because of the same reason, because the inductance gains a very huge voltage, and at the open contact it ionizes the gas, causing a spark to appear. Okay, so this is all about the inductor. You can learn more about inductor and inductance on Google. Okay, so let's just move to the main circuit of the tube light. So here is the main circuit of the tube light, and you can see, okay, so here is the supply voltage appearing. Okay, here. Okay, so it can be 220 volt, 5 ampere current or something like that appearing over here. Okay, so the current begins to flow. Let us consider the supply has been given. This is the ballast. Okay, this is the ballast or the inductor. It is the same thing. It is also called choke. It looks like this one, this figure. Okay, this figure. Okay, and here is our tube light. Here is the tube light. Here is the starter. Okay, here's the starter. Okay, it looks like this. So here is the whole circuit up here. Okay, so I just gave you all a brief overview of how the circuit is there. So let us consider the supply voltage is given here. Okay, so the voltage is around 220 volt or 230 volt, whatever you say. So 220 volt has been applied, the standard voltage. Okay, and current is 5 ampere or 6 ampere, like that. Okay, so the current is flowing. Okay, so when the voltage is applied, the current will start flowing, but in this direction it will tend to move, but because it is open here, this is the starter point, this is open. Okay, this is nothing but the starter is nothing but a bimetallic strip or bimetallic switch. Okay, I will come to it, what is a bimetallic, but before that let us see what is the main circuit in which the tube light is working. So this is the tube light tube, you see. Okay, no interconnection is there, so no current is flowing. Okay, within this, and this is the inductor or the ballast or the choke, whatever you say. So the current is flowing through here, through this terminal, and it will discontinue at this point. Okay, this will discontinue. Now what is this? This is the starter. What is the nature of starter? And starter is a bimetallic switch, as I just later discussed on. What happens at a bimetallic strip when a voltage is applied which is very very high? Okay, like in this case the 220 volt has been applied. So if the voltage is very high, which is generally for this bimetallic switch, so what happens, as I said, at the open terminals, here the terminals are open, at the open terminal the gas ionizes. What? Okay, so in case of a starter there is neon gas which ionizes very quickly than air. Okay, the neon gas is here, so neon gas is present at this contact point, so it ionizes very fastly and a spark is seen. Okay, that is what happens when we just switch on the tube light. The current begins to flow, and here eventually in the starter we see a flash appearing. This is because of this same thing, because of the ionization of the neon gas within the starter tube. And what happens, the gas ionizes and there is a spark. Because of this spark, the switch terminal, okay, let us see this terminal. This terminal heats up. What is the nature of a bimetallic strip? When it heats up, it tries to bend. Okay, that is the nature. So eventually this switch which is here, this contact begins to heat and it begins to expand. So if a thing is like this, when it expands, it becomes like this. Okay, so it will touch this one. Okay, it will touch the other point. Okay, and the switch will be like this. It will be like contacted. The contact will close. Okay, the contact will close. Let me clear this all up. So the contact which is open now closes. Okay, the contact closes because of the ionization. Okay, so the current begins to flow in the normal phase like this. Okay, the current begins to flow from here to here again. Okay, and now what happens is more interesting here. As the current is flowing, the voltage at the terminal which was open is the terminal at the starter which was open is now closed. Okay, the terminal which was open is now closed. So the current is flowing. So what is the voltage again here? 0 volt. Okay, as the current is flowing, the voltage is 0 and there is no spark or nothing else. The current is flowing normally, and that what happens, the bimetallic strip which was like this, on heated up it became like this, and as the current is flowing normally, there is no voltage appearing or there is no spark. The strip again cools down, the switch cools down, and again the switch opens. Okay, the switch again backs to its normal position. It is now back to its normal position. Okay, again the contact is open. Now because of opening of this contact, 220 volt is here. Okay, and as I said, an ideally infinite voltage appears at the inductor because the contact has been opened. This contact is open, and because of this, the inductor, as I shown in the last slide, a huge voltage appears. Okay, so as if we say the plus is here and the minus is here, for the inductor it becomes opposite. The minus becomes here and the plus becomes here. So because of this plus voltage, both are added up. Okay, like the 220 volt here and the infinite volt, ideally it is few thousand volt, that comes over here at this contact point. Okay, and at this contact point. Okay, so spark appears in the tube light also, and also at the contact point of the starter. Okay, but this spark is not enough to light this tube light. Why? Because the length of this tube light is very long, so the spark goes off very quickly. Okay, so again the spark which is appearing here, because of this, the bimetallic strip switch which was like this again touches, again the current begins to flow in normal direction. Okay, so the current, as it is again touching because of the heating, it again touches very fastly, because now the voltage is very high because of the inductance. So the spark that appears second time here is very huge. So again the current begins to flow in normal direction like this. Okay, again when this happens, the bimetallic strip cools down very quickly, and again it lifts the contact like this. Because of opening of this contact, again huge voltage appears over here. Okay, because the switch is open again, and because of this huge voltage and this supply voltage, again a spark appears at this point, and again at this point a spark appears. Okay, so again a spark is seen within this and again within this starter, and this goes on continuously. We see that the tube light is sparking once, then putting off, then sparking once, then putting off, and this continues, and same happens in the starter. At a certain instant of time, what happens, there is argon gas within this. Okay, argon gas is within this tube. It is a what called inert gas. An inert gas. Inert gas means that gas which does not react normally. Okay, so what happens, sparking over a continuous time, as the sparking appears very fastly, at a certain instant of time, what happens, the gas within this tube light ionizes and it becomes a continuous current path. Okay, this ionization now results in a continuous current path through this tube light, and the tube light begins to glow. Okay, whatever the voltage is appearing is now the current now flows through this path. okay, because of the ionization, the current is now flowing through this path. Okay, there is many other theory behind this. There is ultraviolet radiation that happens within this tube, and there is a phosphor layer on the tube light which actually emits light upon electron transition. But I'm not going through that other part, that is another part. But because of this ionization in the tube light, the conduction now become happening through this point, okay, and eventually the starter which was there, the starter remains inactive, the starter remains in off position. That's why we see that after blinking few times, it blinks once and the tube light gets on and the starter becomes off. Okay, so this is the working principle of the tube light. This is how a tube light works. Okay, thanks for watching. I hope you have liked this video. If you have liked this video, subscribe to my channel and also share this with your friends. And I have recently started a blog named The Electrical Engineer. Okay, so please go there, and the link has been also provided in the description. Okay, so the link is this, theelectricalengineer.blogspot.com. So visit here. I will be adding some of the very interesting questions and topics related to electrical engineering, which are very good. Okay, so thanks for watching, and do not forget to subscribe to my channel and also to my blog. So this is Vivek Chaube signing off. Thank you.